Scythe may not be a familiar name to many American PC enthusiasts, but they have quite a reputation for CPU cooling abroad. Howdy howdy guys, Ponchado here, and today we'll be taking a look at one of their mainstream coolers, the Mugen 5 Revision B. Quick note before somebody calls me an idiot in the comments, a lot of people pronounce Mugen wrong. It's not Mugen, it's not Mugen, it's Mugen. Scythe is a Japanese company, Mugen is the Japanese word for infinite, and yeah, I know it sounds weird surrounded by English. Anyway, the Mugen 5 Revision B is an updated version of the Mugen 5 which adds support for the AM4 socket. For the sake of brevity, I'll just be calling it the Mugen 5 from here on. It was released in April of 2017 for around $48 and is compatible with AM4, LGA 1151, and LGA 2066 sockets. Scythe doesn't rate it for a specific TDP, but based on similarly sized and spec'd coolers, it should be able to handle around 200 watts. The front of the box has the info you'd expect, picture, model, and socket compatibility. The side shows off some of the major features like the asymmetric heatsink and their mounting system, the back has a multilingual wall of text describing their warranty outside Japan, and the other side has a dimension drawing and most of the specs, again in multiple languages. Scythe, commendably, doesn't leave anything to the imagination here. Inside the box, right on top, is a smaller box with all the accessories, mounting hardware, thermal paste, instructions, and a funny looking screwdriver which you'll need for installation. Below that sits the 11 blade fan, and finally underneath that is the heatsink itself wrapped in a protective foam cocoon. The first thing you'll notice is that this is a pretty bulky cooler, which should lend itself well to quiet cooling. The base is nickel plated copper with a near mirror finish, and the six 6mm heat pipes are likewise nickel plated copper. Maybe the most important feature of the heatsink is its offset asymmetric design. With the heatsink set back slightly, the fan stays completely clear of the RAM slots. The Mugen 5 also has slightly shorter fins on the bottom of the rear side to allow up to 55mm tall DIMMs for systems with front and rear RAM slots. Finally, as a little aesthetic boost, all six heat pipes have aluminum caps for a cleaner, more polished look. The fan is part of Scythe's Kaze Flex line, a 120mm PWM controlled model with a fluid dynamic bearing. It's rated for 300 to 1200 RPM, which is actually a notably slower and therefore quieter range than most CPU coolers. It doesn't have any LEDs, and it comes with rubberized pads on the corners to decouple it from the heatsink. By having a buffer between the fan and the heatsink, vibration from the fan won't be transmitted as easily, and the cooler should produce less noise as a result. The Mugen 5 also includes a second set of fan clips for a push-pull configuration. Overall, the Mugen 5 is 155mm tall, 130mm wide, and 110mm deep. With Scythe's updated mounting system for the Revision B, the cooler can be mounted horizontally on AM4 systems so air flows front to back. Installation on AM4 systems is pretty easy since the crossbar is already installed in the heatsink and it uses the existing AM4 backplate. The first step is to remove the stock clips on the socket since the Mugen uses its own mounting bracket. With those removed, you place the four spacers over the threaded mounting holes and then screw down the brackets to the socket. It is a little hard to hold in place while screwing them in since they don't quite balance on the spacers, but it's a relatively painless process. With the brackets in place, the next step is to put down a blob of the included thermal grease. Fun time here, I let it sit way too long without the cap, so it got plugged. In trying to unstick it, I sprayed out half the syringe on my hand. Nice. Friendly reminder, don't leave thermal grease uncapped like some sort of caveman. Fortunately, I only wasted half the tube and not all of it, so I only had a little bit to clean up. Anyway, after getting my hands cleaned up, I put down a blob of thermal paste in the middle of the CPU. With the thermal paste down, next comes the heatsink. It has a protective plastic cover on the base, so make sure to remove that first, otherwise you'll have a bad time. Technically, the Mugen 5 could go either direction with airflow toward the front or toward the back, but in all but the weirdest of cases, like the ones with motherboard IO shields on the front or whatever crazy stuff they do, you'll want yours aimed toward the back. To install the heatsink, all you need to do is line up the front and rear screws on the crossbar with the holes in the mounting bracket, then set it down. Once it's in place, you just alternate tightening both screws until they're fully screwed down. As you can see, it's a pretty solid connection. The last step of installation is attaching the fan. This is actually a two-part process since you'll need to push the fan clips into the fan mounting holes first. I actually like this a lot better than regular fan clips, which require you to hold them in place while mounting the fan. On the Mugen 5, the clips are positively held to the fan and you just need to hook them on the heatsink. RAM clearance on the front is a non-issue since the Mugen 5 sits completely behind the RAM slots, and memory up to 55mm in height can fit under the backside for those systems with two sets of RAM slots. That should accommodate all but the most ridiculous heat spreaders. With it all installed and ready to go, let's get to testing. My test bench is a Ryzen 3 1200 overclocked to 4.1 GHz at 1.35 volts on an MSI B350M Gaming Pro motherboard with 8GB of DDR4 2400 memory. The graphics card is a passively cooled GT 1030 from MSI, and thanks to Seasonic for providing the power supply, an 850W Focus Plus Gold which can run passive under low load. The Because the GT1030 and Seasonic 850FX run passive cooling and don't produce noise, the only sound coming from this system is from the CPU cooler itself. Load temperatures are taken with the CPU running a Prime 95 stress test, temperatures are allowed to stabilize, then averaged over 3 runs, and cooling results are reported as deltas, degrees above ambient temperature. First, we'll look at the idle results. These are the noise levels and temperature deltas with no programs running and the fans at their minimum RPM. Owing to its low minimum speed of around 400 RPM, the Mugen 5 is exceptionally quiet at idle. Ambient noise in my studio is roughly 29 decibels, and any sound below 30 or 31 dB is effectively inaudible, even with the cooler running in open air on a table just a few feet away. Now we'll look at the max cooling results. These measurements are taken under load with the fans at full speed to show the upper limit of their cooling. In terms of temperature, the Mugen 5 fell behind the other tower coolers in AIO I've tested, but it was second from the top in terms of noise at just over 43 decibels. Even running at full tilt, this is not a loud cooler. Next, we'll take a look at the RPM versus PWM graph to show the granularity of control you can achieve with the fan. The Mugen 5 is one of the few coolers I've tested that allows control over the complete PWM range. Whether you're going from 0 to 1% or 99 to 100, even the smallest step will elicit a change. Interestingly, the curve isn't quite straight, but rather levels off asymptotically. Not that that means a whole lot in the real world, but it is the first time I've seen a fan do that. Now here's the delta C versus RPM graph to show whether the cooler is limited by airflow or by heat transfer. A leveling off at higher RPM indicates the cooler is limited by heat transfer, while a consistent drop in delta indicates airflow is the limiting factor. In most cases, tower coolers and AIOs are limited by heat transfer, while top-down and low-profile coolers are limited by airflow. The Mugen 5 indeed is limited by heat transfer rather than airflow. You can see the temperature delta remains nearly unchanged from just under 1000 RPM all the way up to its max speed. One takeaway from this is that adding a second fan and push-pull won't necessarily allow it to reach lower temperatures, though it may reduce the noise level at any given delta. Now here's the most important graph for performance, temperature delta versus noise. This answers the fundamental question for any CPU cooler: how loud is it and how well does it cool? The Mugen 5 falls roughly in the middle of the pack of tower coolers in terms of delta, but excels in noise performance since the fan's PWM range extends down quite a bit. You can also see here the cooling limit, since the delta levels off at about 39 degrees, and though you can run the fan faster and louder, it won't produce lower temps, at least on this test setup. Now here's the chart of cooler scores, which are essentially how close the cooler gets to a hypothetical perfect cooler with a 0 degree delta and 0 decibels of noise. You can think of this as a metric to compare coolers running at their optimal speed, balanced between cooling performance and noise level. The Mugen 5 nearly hit the highest tier here, just a couple points short. Not bad. Finally, cooler score per dollar to show price to performance. The Mugen 5 hits in the middle of the pack at just under 1 point per dollar. Something to keep in mind here is that every cooler with a higher price to performance ratio here is also quite a bit cheaper. It's often the case with any computer components that purely in terms of price to performance, cheaper parts win. Now for the pros and cons. First up, the pros. Installation was super easy, other than the thermal grease exploding on my hands, which was my fault anyway. Scythe obviously exerted some effort here to make it as painless as possible, which is especially nice because large tower coolers like this are often a hassle to install. Second, it's a very quiet cooler while still cooling well. Under both idle and load conditions, the Mugen 5 matched or beat all but one other cooler in terms of noise. As for the cons, it's somewhat limited on the upper end of cooling, despite its large size. Maybe this isn't so much a con as it is specialization. The Mugen 5 was designed to be extremely quiet, not cool as much as possible with no regard to noise. I think it meets that goal well. The Mugen 5 is one of the better overall CPU coolers I've tested and one of the best in terms of noise. It's big but includes smart design choices that make RAM clearance a non-issue. It's heavy but the installation brackets are secure and really easy to install. You won't be breaking any overclocking records with the Mugen 5, but I don't think that was ever the point. It's a cooler that was designed to handle a reasonable overclock while maintaining whisper quiet acoustics, and it does exactly that. It's actually really unfortunate that Scythe doesn't have a bigger presence in the US. They produce a number of highly rated designs. Fortunately though, the Mugen 5 is available here and it's a solid performer. Click the link in the description to pick one up for yourself. Hit subscribe and click the bell icon to get notified of new videos as soon as they're up. So guys, if you like this video, hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit subscribe. And if you have any questions on the Scythe Mugen 5, leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, I hope I helped, and I'll see you in the next video.